you everyone for coming. First thing on the agenda is our continued discussion and potential final action on the site review plan for alternative self-storage. I think we have, if you
yes.
want to... Kevin will be recusing
himself from
comment and voting on... do you want to just
absolutely
bring us up to date on the latest round of changes?
Absolutely, Mr. Chairman. Again, in terms of the planning board and for the record, Scott Law from the White Plains here with me tonight is Mark Wentworth, co-owner of Alternative Self-Storage LLC. As we presented last month to the planning board, the applicant is proposing seven 2,800 square foot self-storage buildings off of Greenview Drive. As we discussed, Greenview Drive is essentially a north-south orientated road, and this is located in a piece of parcel about 2.5 acres. It's in zone industrial, and they're proposing to install these buildings with pavement around the perimeter of it. At the board, we discussed there was the site would not be manned. It would essentially be a access only. It's a gated. We'll have a gate at the entrance, and that'll be operated by a key entrance. There won't be any employees. As such, we are not proposing any sort of public utilities or water or sewer, septic or anything like that. We will have one underground electrical conduit installed to provide lighting for the buildings, and that's all that will be serviced other than electrical for some security cameras. So on the buildings, we've got a series of downshielded wall packs, and there's one pole mounted light pole at the entrance for the illumination of the entrance. Since the last board meeting, we did conduct a site walk with many of you. We went out and looked at the location of everything. Also, during the past month, we've had the drainage reviewed by civil consultants as requested by the board. We received their comments. Essentially, their comments were some minor clarifications to some of the construction details, and they asked us to look at the storage in the pond to make sure that we have 1 foot of freeboard and a 50-year storm event. The result of that required just an ever so slight increase in the basin to account for that, make sure that we had that 1 foot of freeboard during the 50-year storm event. So we responded back to civil consultants with a list of addressing all their comments. And I believe the board received a letter recently with their sign-off on the application. There was one minor caveat about getting authorization from the road agent with regards to the culvert underneath the driveway to make sure that we had 3 feet of cover or the road agent sign-off on it. Mr. Wentworth has met with the road agent. We just received today a handwritten letter indicating he was fine with this. I printed out a copy of the hands of the board and proceeded to leave it at my desk at the office.
Oh.
But I can forward that to the secretary via email. But we didn't get that. He had no problems with the design. And again, we have over 2 feet of cover, just didn't have the 3 feet of cover that typically likes to see. I think that's generally a case where if it's a town or going to be a town road, they'd like to see that 3 feet of cover over pipes. Where this is essentially a drainage pipe service in a private industry, I think the road agent felt that over 2 feet was adequate cover. Another result of our sidewalk is that we were, part of it was to focus about the appearance criteria. As you recall, we did request a waiver to allow for the use of metal siding, which is typically not allowed within the site review regulation. Mr. Krebs also suggested to the board that we might look at whether or not the applicant needs to provide some additional landscaping to help break up that. The sense of I got from the board during the sidewalk was that most felt that this was an appropriate location for this type of use. In consulting with the applicant, we did decide to add trees along the perimeter. They're spaced about 80 feet, so there's about 13 trees that would be installed around the perimeter, as you can see, and that'll help break up the appearance again off of Greenview Drive. That'll continue to be wooded as it is today, so that provides ample screening from majority of the people going up and down Greenville Drive. Again, that's an industrial zone driveway or road that surfaces industrial uses. So that is a very quick, broad overview of where we, what changes we've applied to the plan since our last meeting.
Yep.
And if the board has any questions, I'm gladly answer them to the best of my ability.
All right. When I open up for questions.
All my questions were answered. If you have a sidewalk, John. I didn't have any to begin with, so.
Okay.
John had some concerns, but it sounds like they were addressed, so.
Yep. Okay. Well, hearing none, I think we're ready to take final action on this. Entertain a motion to approve the plan.
Have we accepted it as complete? Did we grant the waivers?
Except for the building material.
In light of the landscaping that Scott proposed, is the building material waiver acceptable? I would assume it's acceptable.
I don't think that putting wood siding on these buildings makes any sense. I think that would eventually look worse. So I don't have any issue with that.
So we didn't officially adopt that. What number was that?
I think it was.
It is 13D2.
That we grant an exemption to rule 13D2?
Yep. Paragraph 13, section D2.
All right, do I hear a second?
A second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Hearing none, the waiver passes. Now I think we need a motion to accept the plan as a whole.
Yeah, motion to approve the plan, and I'm just trying to think what the only the conditions that I have are, and I was scrambling to write these down. The first one is that the final approval of the town engineer, I'm assuming, has he given you a green light for everything now?
The road agent, you mean?
No, the town engineer.
Consultants, yes, we provided the board with a copy of their letter.
Emailed. Everything's done.
That's correct.
Okay, so then I get the two conditions I have so far are that I would assume that his fees have been paid. The civil consultant's fees have been paid or have to be paid before the plan is signed. The second thing is that I think that all the landscaping has got to be installed, which includes trees, loam, seed, prior to occupancy of the building. I don't know what else I've got.
Well, I don't know. Just a comment from my point of view, if we start this project, by the time we get it going, it may not be time of year to, adequately landscape it. And if we have the buildings finished and the site work done, it'd be kind of a hardship on me to not occupy them until we can.
Can we give an extension until the spring?
Well, what's reasonable?
Well, like I said, we still got to get this thing off the ground and built. So I would think, within a year, I should have it in. Is that reasonable?
I mean,
this time next year? Or spring?
I think spring is
fine. It's practical.
Yeah,
sure.
Absolutely. Yeah. If you open up in December, you're not going to plant a tree. That's fine. I agree.
I'd like to have it. be able to be occupied and use it.
Sure, no, yeah, that makes sense, sure. But I don't want to make it complicated by saying you're gonna get a...
Well, we probably wouldn't...
Surety or something.
Forego construction until next year, because...
No, no, I don't, I think that's reasonable, I just, you know, I don't, whatever the board, you know, if it's by June 1st of...
Yeah, I mean, that's reasonable.
You know, no later than June 1st, you know?
It's fine with me.
But as long as you make every effort to get them in the ground.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
You know, if you can do it this fall, great, if not, by June 1st, is that reasonable?
Yeah, that's fine, and if we can do it this fall, that would be great too, I mean, I just know how things go, and we're already in July, so...
Yep.
And you want to arrange with Mrs. Lammer in the select board office, payment to civil consultant?
Okay, right.
So I guess that's all I have, is just the final payment of the town engineer, and then the, all landscaping shown on the plan shall be installed no later than June 1st, 2018. But that every effort should be made to install it this year if possible.
I'll move that we approve the plan with the following conditions. Payment to the town engineer for site review, and landscaping to be completed no later than June 1st of the...
2018.
Of 2018, I think.
Yeah, yeah, like I said, we'll do it this fall if they...
Yeah, sure, that's fine.
So, does that make sense?
That makes sense.
Yep, I think that's fair.
Do I hear a second?
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed, hearing none? It's approved.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the planning board.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So Scott, we don't, I know there's a signature block in here, what are you gonna do with that amount? We don't record site plans, so...
Do you still want a final set of plans? Well, I guess the plans that I submitted were...
I think they're final.
Yeah.
Except the only thing you didn't do was list the waiver.
I could add that.
Can you, I mean, I don't want to make you print off 35 sheets again, but could you at least print...
I could add it to the cover sheet.
An addendum or something.
A couple, you know, just give us a couple of complete sets, maybe two or three just for the file, with the waivers granted, and just for your, really to protect yourself, so your record is clear, you know? I think you did list the waivers, didn't you?
No, I did not.
Ken, why don't you list the waivers granted? I would suggest, and you can even, if you want to, you know, I can give you these back, but you can substitute these. Okay, it's only paper.
Pat had been signing this, I just found...
Well, he signs it, but we don't record them.
No, we record them.
So...
And really, I only...
It'd be good if Miles signed it, just so, but why don't you, so if you wouldn't mind, just revise this by listing the waivers that were granted, and then just arrange to have Miles sign them, and just have it part of the record.
Absolutely, he has been doing it on Tuesday night, town hall open later.
Okay.
It was more convenient for him, but...
Yeah, we can arrange it. The last thing I signed, the guy came to my office.
Okay. We finally approved what he was signing.
I'm flexible. Thank you very much.
Thank you much.
Thank you. All right, next step on the agenda, approval of the minutes. Sarah sent out the minutes last... A motion to accept. All in favor of approving the minutes?
Aye.
All opposed, hearing none? No minutes passed. Correspondence, there was this planning room that, from Civil Works. So, this is about the C&amp;J addition, 25-foot, 110-foot building.
On the back lot?
See, I remember when they were in here, like, I don't know, it was like 5 to 6 months ago.
Well, there was some confusion with them a year and a half ago back regarding the original building and an addition to the rear, to the existing original building that was added without our, that I never added.
Okay.
But that was probably 16, right?
No, earlier than that.
Yeah, it was.
15, 14?
It was.
Is that the original building was up?
It was, right.
Yeah, well, that's...
But then he's been back since...
He's been back to...
Right, and he's done some...
I haven't seen what...
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what he's asking for.
New building.
It sounds like they're asking to reduce the number of required parking spaces.
Do you have this in electronically?
No, I just, it was just in the, it was just in the planning board, planning room.
Parking.
So the letter, by the way, said July 18, 2014.
Oh, I'm sorry, is this like label?
You're like really, oh my god.
Well, I saw July 18th, it's not even, doesn't.
No, I just have a letter saying July 16th.
I thought he dealt with it.
So, this is further evidence that the.
Finally, you're speaking.
Okay, forget it. There was a pamphlet, which I'm pretty sure is new.
Check the date.
Oh, wait, this is from 11. No, no, I'm joking. No, let's jump now. So there is no correspondence. Conflict of interest paperwork, I think everyone signed one. Did you sign one?
I don't know. I need to sign one.
No, you need to sign one. John, have you signed one? As an employee, you have to sign one. Well, you don't, but you should.
Don't have.
Yeah.
You can read it?
I haven't read it yet.
Well,
I mean,
first of all, I mean, let me set the stage, but first of all, it's important, I think, as a municipality to have conflict of interest policy in general that we didn't have before, but this was a condition of the bond council, actually, for the action from town meeting.
Oh, okay.
To issue certain bonds in certain months, we needed the town needs to have an official policy. And when we said, of course we have one, and then we researched it, and then we don't, so.
Do you want a copy of the, if you don't want it, you can leave it there.
I like to.
Yeah, I did.
You choose that page.
I think I've already kind of discussed it.
Okay.
And if you serve on multiple boards, you don't have to.
What's that?
If you're on multiple boards, like you've already been, so you're covering it one.
We haven't done it at the ZBA.
Okay. Well,
I can barely get
the next one.
Fees passed. That's the next
one. They'll need to do that as well. So.
I just got to finish reading. I'll finish
sure,
it for the
sure.
Other meeting.
Okay.
So
you know what, John? If you want to just give it to me next meeting, that's fine.
Okay.
Was there any other business to
come the last time we were here, we had guests at the end of the meeting. Our legal counsel and their legal counsel are working some things out.
Okay.
So I don't expect you to be seeing them again until they work out.
Okay.
It could be next month, but I just wanted to keep
yep.
That.
And Mike, when you say work things out, I'm assuming that...
So issues around the process,
okay.
Around the process.
And would there be any... I'm assuming the town council wouldn't make an agreement without input from us as to...
Great. And are we, as a town, paying for this review and service and representation? It just doesn't seem fair.
We have contacts. We have lots of ongoing legal issues with a number of parties, so we
keep it on the pile.
It's
no, but
no
I mean,
one's favorite thing to have to do, but it's in our best interest to do it. So.
But when someone has a valid, arguable point, they're right to hear it.
Well, just to back up, Mike, you said something to John. You said, would this board be made either aware of the your decision? There's a couple, there's a bunch of steps that have to happen. Some of them are solely controlled by the Board of Selectmen. So, in other words, issuing building permits on a class.
Sure,
that's
right.
Their issue.
Right.
Then we have other issues. So I think you guys have authority to do other things that beyond our purview.
I think the applicant and his counsel and our town legal counsel thought it was everyone's best interest to sit down,
sure.
Have
a
conversation about the entire process before either party went any further. So that's why we're.
But this is not only select board and planning board, this is also ZBA. They have ZBA issues, depending on what access point they choose.
May or may not.
Yeah, potentially, yeah. I mean, we don't have an official application yet, so it's
yeah, but I think the biggest thing is the process of how it was handled thus far.
Is this the root of the problem, is that we don't have a process? I mean,
no. Just to go back, because I don't know how many people were. This is a weird, weird situation. You know, there's a Class 6 road that I think the LaVoys assumed they could upgrade without, but there's questions as to whether or not they need both the Board of Selectmen's approval, potentially the town meeting's approval, and whether or not, that's one issue. The other issue is whether or not they'll issue a building permit out of Class 6 road.
Right.
And then we have our own issues about whether we'll allow a subdivision on what really isn't road frontage, so that, which could be a variance issue. So it's only a two-lot subdivision, so it should be relatively easy, but there's a lot of, you know, I don't think anybody on this board, any other board, was trying to throw a wrench in the works. I just think that it was a ship that was sailing without a captain, and they were just, you know, go here, go there, go there, and maybe it would have been smarter to do this powwow with the lawyers, to sort of decide how they want to. The ball's in their court as to how they want to proceed. So they could have done another thing.
They could have simply gone in different directions. So right. There wasn't any one direction. I think there were several at the time. So I think that's what we're trying to sort of streamline.
But I do think, in some of the correspondence I read, that some of the issues at hand consist of being advised to proceed with development costs by perhaps a board member or even a board chair, in which they proceeded to do and got into it for substantial money. And ultimately, when that money's been spent and now it's been brought back, it's been brought to their attention that, oh, well, you know, that shouldn't happen.
Anyone who wants to do a subdivision of any kind in this community needs to have plans drawn.
Absolutely.
So they need to have the guidance of a professional. Just dealt with a very simple one.
You could have denied Mark Wentworth tonight. He would have been a whatever it was, 25 grand, 15 grand, 30 grand. That's the risk you take. You know, there's no.
Well,
there's
the
no,
risk you take, if I may speak, is that you can deny that, but it fits absolutely everything in our guidance.
I shouldn't have picked that. But there's always a risk, you know, that when you try to do a subdivision or a site plan or anything else, you may not get to the finish line. Or maybe you're going to get to the finish line with, you thought you were going to get 7 lots, you get 5 lots. I mean, you know, we're not responsible for people spending money to try, you know, trying to get a.
And it is required to proceed
sure.
with the plan.
But
you can't use that as an example.
I shouldn't have used it. I'm just saying there's no guarantees with any plan that walks in this door that we're going to approve it. I mean, rarely do we deny, but because most
then realistically,
people know,
then, if I can follow up that, really what is there to pursue? If they were denied after we received all the information, why should they have a problem with that?
You're concerned about us discussing
on
the record
the actual
application
or whatever with the folks. I just wanted the board to. They thought they were coming back this month.
Yeah.
They said it at the meeting when we were all here. We'll be back next month. Just letting you know they're not here because their legal counsel and the town's legal counsel have some issues they want to work out before they bring it back here. That's the only thing I want to discuss. That's what I want to let you all know. If you're wondering why they didn't come back this month.
And time frame where you anticipate that there'll be. You're an intelligent man. You can make an estimate.
Would be very surprised.
Not inside of 30 or 60 days. I don't think we're two lawyers talking.
I don't know. Yeah, I think part of the problem is.
Can I?
The lawyers have to be responsive.
This is not a agenda topic.
Right. Can I make one more final suggestion on this application? They did submit, I think they submitted an application, because I got a package from Paul. And then I quickly got a phone call from Paul saying, please don't review it, because we don't know what's going to happen. So, but if they submit an application without fees, is that just in La La Land now, or should we ask them just to
I think we need to be
he withdrew it.
They formally withdrew the application.
That's what Carolyn told me.
Okay.
Until they get this stuff sorted out. But,
okay.
So it's.
I just want to make sure. I don't think they paid fees, and I just.
No.
Okay.
They haven't paid fees.
Not that I want to throw gas on fire, but it's not fair to submit another application and not pay fees. So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anything else?
Does anybody remember Paul's auto?
Yes, we're working on it.
Okay, thank you.
You mean the boat and the box truck and the multiple vehicles that are...
We spent a lot of time making sure that there wasn't going to be...
Do you remember when that was? Caroline asked me to pull the paperwork, but it was pre-me, so I wasn't sure.
It was pre-me too, so...
I would say last spring?
No, because it's not the Baldex site, it's the other site.
Oh, I'm talking about the one he's moved into now.
Baldex?
He's got cars down the side, way beyond the parking lot.
Yeah, but that could also be people that live across the street, because they do use that.
They do, they do.
And that was the woman that spoke on his behalf, and she said, we love Paul.
Okay.
But on that same thought, I mean, that, the former Paul's garage...
Joe's garage.
Joe's garage, but the vehicle for sale, which was...
That blue truck?
Yeah, that was the one.
Is that the site?
Like the unregistered vehicles?
That's the one we need, I think.
So do you remember when... There's a boat being stored there, there's a box truck being stored there.
Unregistered vehicles.
These were all conditions that Mr. Miller had to...
Do you remember when that original site was approved?
No.
Okay.
It was a long time ago.
Yeah, it was like pre-2004.
So we're trying to pull the conditions so we can show them to the new occupant. You have to meet the same conditions.
Is it the same owner?
No.
Yeah, the same property owner.
Oh, Brandt.
No, because Paul, who now has the Baldex site.
But Paul never owned the property.
But he knows the property.
It's, what's his name, Brandt Heck?
No, his last name was Brandt.
Brandt Sheen.
He's the developer. I don't know, his brother lives there too.
Oh, right.
Henry or Harvey or Henry?
Hank.
Hank.
Brandt.
Got their eventual G-A sort of...
But the issues are not with the structure, it's the issues are with how the business may run there.
Well, that's a compliance issue with the board.
That's what we're working on, so that's, but we need to get the copy of the conditions.
I think it was pre-14. I mean, it was a while.
I'm coming in tomorrow morning to take you.
Why'd you start in 2004? I don't think it was before then.
Anything else to come before the board?
I'm going to throw out a suggestion again, and it's like a broken record, that we need to set, I think we have to set an agenda that's maybe we don't, to discuss future legislative goals, and even things like what Kevin's brought up. I mean, maybe we need to, just tweak the fees, and I don't know if we can build in something again in terms of recapturing costs, but I think that, again, I'm not going to belabor it, but I think that we should have a meeting that talks about what our goals are. We're in July, and before you know it, it's going to be, the deadline's going to go fast.
And John had offered you a training as well.
Right.
Overview of and...
Do we know if we have anything coming in August?
In August, the fellow that bought the Bluins Mill is going to come in and talk to us about his plans. It's an informal discussion. So this seems fairly light. I mean, if the Lavoie application comes through, it is only 3 weeks away.
And the deadline for that is when?
I think it's today, isn't it?
No. We have 10 calendar days.
Okay.
What I was going to suggest, Miles, is if we don't have anything else other than that guy, you do that then.
Yep, I think that's a great idea.
So it would have to be like by next Thursday, by the 20th or so, that they would have to say, pull the trigger.
Or something else could stroll,
Yep.
Sure.
Yep.
I don't know if anyone's coming, but...
I haven't heard of anything.
All right, why don't we plan to get that...
So I think born out of that conversation then can be what we want to see moving forward. I would think.
So you want to add that to the agenda?
Yeah.
If we can... I know the Economic Development Committee never really got off the ground, did it? I had heard through the grapevine, I think Paul Conley grapevine, that he was denied a variance do storage down Oak Street.
Yep.
Were they?
Yep.
Next to the tracks, right?
Yeah.
The ZBA.
Yeah.
Is that, we've talked about that at this board, rezoning that section of Oak Street Commercial. I mean, do you think that that's worth putting the agenda in, at least giving us some food, you know, at least people would think about it for a couple of weeks before or a
month?
I think
what killed that application was, or that appeal, was the traffic issue. Because that somebody else had tried to develop that same site, and what killed it then was the traffic. Just to have industrial on that narrow bit of road.
Dover has one, the other side of the street.
Yeah, I mean, the
I guess one thing I would say is that it's getting to the point where who would want to live there? You know, the traffic there is getting increasing.
The abutters are pretty passionate.
They are?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it would give them a choice, you know, if they decided, you know, if they wanted to sell their house. I mean, it might, I'm not suggesting we do it, but we've talked about, that's the one area of town we've talked about rezoning it. Maybe we'd give people a couple weeks to at least chew on it, and maybe we talk about it, maybe we don't, or, you know, maybe we decide it's not, the time isn't right.
But it might be the highest and best use of the property and also an opportunity for the town to earn a little bit more money revenue-wise.
Well, that's what we're talking about.
Because now this gentleman's house, if you do a certain larger parcel with several lots, the value of their structure, not as a structure, but as a locale, and I think that no one's ever going to build a residence. I mean, the site used to have oil tanks on it. It's right beside a railroad bed. It's right before a wooden bridge. No, you know, it's got to be, it'll sit there and we'll collect no taxes on it forever.
I just think it's the one rezoning we've talked about to try to broaden your tax base. But it's never really, we never really gone anywhere with it, but maybe this is, that was that, it was that application sort of made me think maybe it's time to at least look at it.
Without comments, a lot of the ZBA have been voted on that. I'll just tell you that the vote was like 4-1 against it. It was a good turnout. And issues were raised by traffic and other neighbors. There are neighbors on that road who are residents on that road, they live in Rollinsford, that essentially, I think the record would reflect that feel like they take their lives in their hands to get out of the driveway at times. So I think without revisiting it or
go ahead. But I think part of also the reason they appealed on hardship, on the owner of this land, it's been paying tax on it forever, it's not worth anything, he can't sell it now, someone's looking at putting a storage unit on it. And he was denied it, saying that's not a hardship because you can still build a house on there. Well, you cannot build a house. It's not a big enough lot.
It's the size of a lot.
It's a narrow, long, you can't build a house on that.
I mean, we were talking miles from, I think the whole...
Yeah, but I know it doesn't fit. It doesn't fit setbacks and everything.
Route 4?
To Route 4, just
maybe back so many feet, 400 feet, 300 feet. We just sort of talked about it conceptually maybe a year ago. We never got it off the ground. But.
So how does that impact the people that live there now? So they can now market their properties as commercial?
They could. I mean, we could, yeah, sure. I mean, if that was, I mean, this is almost a year away. It would have to be town meeting 2018.
Yep. Right.
But, and as Sarah says, if people are passionate about living there, then maybe they would be opposed to it. But even if you live there, you say, well, if I want to sell my house, is anybody going to buy it as a home?
Right. I mean, there's one for sale currently, but they're...
That's not all the that 160, that's not all
the they're asking.
And I don't have a strong opinion, but this board at one time was kicking around ideas to try to broaden the tax base.
Yep.
You know, we certainly looked at the downtown area, but most everything here is built, so we're not going to capture a lot more taxes down here because you're not going to build a lot more. Everything's built. And it may increase incrementally. Hopefully, the Blue and Mill will see a boost, but it's not going to be significant. But that's the one area we all know that Route 4 can't be touched. You know, so
that's taboo, right?
What?
That's taboo, and I don't think that there would be an objection from the property owners, because even if it is changed, their grandfather, they can live there until they die. But I think ultimately they will see that at some point, the value of their house, whether they're in the grave and their kids are selling it, or whether they're going to sell it and travel, is worth so much more. And the abutter owns that lot. The abutter owns two lots. The immediate abutter owns that one lot that's just been paid back. Can't do anything.
So again, just that might be one thing to talk about if we have time for the next
meeting.
I think at that meeting we should also set like a 4 or 6 month topic to be thinking about either, you know, as far as procedurally or legislatively or something like that. I do think Pat was always good about keeping us on track about the master plan. Did I say that right? Because John would set it up. We adopted a lot. We actually moved forward on it. Thank you, John.
Well, yeah, and I met with Jeff Apsey today,
about the woolen mill, about other, he wanted to know about parking.
Did he get his question answered about the parking? Because I don't.
He did. Yeah, okay. I talked.
Okay.
But the other question he has is, and this has never been resolved to my knowledge, when Chinburg was doing their subdivision, they were not allowed to have sewer because there was inadequate capacity. The sewer commission didn't know what the capacity was. So I can't remember how many units had sewer over there, but not many, right?
Most of them did. A few of them did, but not all.
Most
of them did,
maybe two.
But I think that, wasn't there some talk about we would like someone else to pay for it.
That's right. They asked Chinburg to pay for a study. They didn't want to pay for the study. They decided to handle it a different way by putting a leach field. The question is, Jeff is talking about doing, residence units, I think 18 or so residence units in the Bullen Mill. It begs the question, is there capacity? Because we don't want to start...
Capacity at the wastewater treatment plant?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it wasn't specific.
Or the
it is.
Pipes.
Yeah, well, it was broad.
Yeah.
I mean, it was...
Okay.
It was, we don't know if we have enough capacity. Whether it's pipe, whether it's infrastructure or the wastewater facility itself. There was an issue with, I think, high levels of nitrates or nitrites getting into the river. But I think it was, that was a separate issue that I think they were dealing with. So... And I don't know if it might be worth just a friendly meeting with a member or members of the Sewer Water Commission, because we don't want to try to push the market for the downtown area if there's no capacity. So I'm sort of hopeful that maybe the Bullen Mill breathes life into that area, but I just hope we don't run into a snag with a lack of infrastructure. So that, I don't know who to invite. John, Mike
LaPointe.
Mike LaPointe.
You might be the best about everything.
He might be someone who would be willing to come in and just address, speak to the board about that.
Okay.
He comes in and works with us as well.
Yeah.
He's been very helpful. So.
Scott McLendon, is he involved in that too? At one time he was the man.
He's not any longer now.
Did we use him for consultation on something?
Yeah.
When he was not, after
he's,
he's
been working on our wastewater issue.
Yeah.
He has a consulting business.
Right. And this is post him working for the town.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought. But I thought he was involved in the discussions regarding
the Chinburg development predates me, so I don't know any of that
really? Yeah.
Happened before I got on the board. So I don't know what the details. I just signed the building permit. That's all. I don't.
Yeah.
Yeah, I noticed there's a flurry of activity over there.
It's like kind of a lot. It's nice. It's nice to see that suit to nuts.
I still don't care for the access to the driveways. Little tar ramps.
I don't hate that sidewalk, but we made it for that.
It's wrong.
Well, maybe it'd be a good field trip for you to drive through that and say, what did we do right, what did we do wrong? It's a lot of times we don't see what happens after.
There aren't curb cuts, so they put in a sidewalk with no curb cut.
Yeah.
So to access the driveway, some people have built like little wooden ramps. You haven't driven up there?
Where is
it?
Which line are you talking about? Scott Lynn. It's the
Lynn.
One to go to... Development there?
Okay. I have a friend that lives in there.
So there's a sidewalk, but there's no curb cut.
There's no curb cut to get over
the
because they use that mountable curb. It's a sort of a...
It's an elevated grade, but if you have a truck...
If you have a Corvette or something, I put photos of that.
My car wouldn't make it over that, but...
Yeah. But it might be worth a ride through there just to see what we get.
I have a feeling it looks like they put it in before they knew where the house is.
And that's always a problem with the subdivision.
Yeah.
We always want to see where the driveways are going, but someone may buy a house and want a right side driveway, someone might buy one that wants a left side driveway. So
there's some pretty tight building envelopes, though, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, they're really less than
those small
ones. Yeah, they were going to be. It does look.
And that's a unique subdivision. I don't think we'll ever see another one.
Well, I guess this winter they kept getting plowed, like the tar little ramps got plowed away.
Well, it shouldn't be there because it's a drivable curve. just because you own the house doesn't mean it's up the road.
Yeah.
Right.
You know, I mean,
exactly.
So that's a selectman issue.
The horse boils the house up.
Well, we can go and look if we got here and it's still light.
Sure. Take a field trip. All right. With that, to entertain a motion to adjourn. Oh, so our next meeting, it says on the agenda that it's August 1st, 2018, but I think we'll meet this year.
You're supposed to.
I didn't notice it until just now.
No kidding.
What date you say?
August 1st. That's the first Tuesday.
You got the right day.
Yeah.
And do we at this point don't know if the Blue and Mill will be on?
They are coming.
It's for sure.
Yep.
Okay. I think it's just an informal. Isn't it?
Yeah. He wants to chat about, you know, what he's thinking. Sounds like you've been in touch with him.
Yep. I've been with him today. Yep.
So with that, I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion.
Second motion.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
I'm sorry.
No,